Ladies and gentlemen, Bernadette Peters.
Once upon a time, in a small town in a land called Texas, a little girl would go to bed at night and have the most wonderful dream. She would be running toward the sky, faster and faster, raising her arms like a great bird until finally she just lifted off the ground and flew away. The dream came night after night until the little girl believed it was true. One morning, she snuck out of the house before dawn and climbed to the top of her family's garage. She ran for the sky, took one great leap, and fell on her face. Well, I understand how she felt, because when I was 5 years old, I had the same dream. The only difference was I was wide awake. I was watching a television special about a magical boy who never grew up and all the wonderful things he could do. And when the show was over, I remember going to bed crying that night because I couldn't fly the way he did. I guess for a few hours, I just knew that anything in the world was possible, because that little girl from Texas had grown up to be Mary Martin, and Mary Martin had grown up to be Peter Pan. And that's what Mary Martin does. She makes us believe, not just in the wonders of Never Never Land, but in the magic of the world we see every day. Mary's unique magic has been a source of constant wonder and envy to all of us who work in the musical theater. Ethel Merman put it best. The night South Pacific opened on Broadway, a reporter cornered her and asked her what she thought of Miss Martin's performance. "Ah, she's all right," Merman snapped, "if you like talent." That remarkable talent was the inspiration for some of the most glorious moments of the musical theater. Night after night, she would reach out her hand and take the audience on a journey that would stay with them forever. And she'd be on that journey too, as surprised by the events and emotions on that stage as we were, as if it were all happening for the first time, and she couldn't wait to see how it all turns out. She makes us believe in the magic of the theater and in the magic of ourselves, because she believes it too. When Captain Hook asked his spirited adversary, "Pan, who and what are you?" the boy replies, "I am youth, I am freedom, I am joy." He might just as well have said, "I am Mary Martin."
Expression.
And if it means I must prepare to shoulder burdens with a worried air,
I'll never grow up, never grow up, never grow up.
Not me, so there.
When she was growing up in Weatherford, Texas, everyone knew little Mary. She loved to put on shows and play all the parts herself. She started a dance school in her Uncle Luke's barn. When it burned to the ground, she said, "It's a sign. Let's go to Hollywood." In 2 years, she'd come to be known as Audition Mary. Then, a break. A Broadway producer asked her to try out for a new show. This girl who had never been inside a real theater.
While carrying on a game of golf, I may make a play for the caddy. But when I do, I don't follow through, 'cause my heart belongs to daddy. If I invite
one song, a mischievous striptease, and suddenly she was bigger than Texas. was already taken.
I'm quick on the trigger with targets.
Ethel Merman had staked it out on Broadway.
I'm number one.
Maybe, Mary thought, I could make it my own on the road.
Got no silver, got no gold. What I got can't be bought or sold. I got the sun in the morning and the moon at night. Anything you can do, I can do better. I can do anything better than you. If you saw my pa and ma, you'd know they had no learning.
She was sweet soprano no more. And that gave Rodgers and Hammerstein an idea. Could Mary carry the lead in their new show? After she sang one song, they said never sing it any other way.
I'm romantic and bright as the moon. Happy night, pouring light on the view. I'm at party in Kansas in August. I had the flag on the 4th of July. If you'll excuse an expression I use, I'm in love, I'm in love, I'm in love, I'm in love, I'm in love. We're the
wash that man right out of my hair and send him on his way. 101 pounds of fun. That's my little honey bun.
There is nothing like a dame. Nothing in the world. There is nothing you can name.
She bounced across the proscenium and settled in as queen of the American musical theater.
Raindrops on roses and whiskers on kittens.
Out of a glorious reign came one more show with Rodgers and Hammerstein. The Sound of Music was their last gift, perhaps their most endearing.
My hymns are alive with the sound of music.
For 50 years, she has showered us with pixie dust and made us believe in make-believe.
If children believed in fairies, if you believe, clap your hands and she'll hear you.
I'm flying.
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 Over bed, over chair, duck your head, clear the air. Oh, what lovely fun. Watch me, everyone. Take a look at me.
The brightest lights on Broadway this season are those on the marquee of the Imperial Theater that say Jerome Robbins Broadway. Here tonight, in tribute to Mary Martin, are members of the cast with Charlotte d'Amboise as Peter Pan.
John, Michael, wake up, wake up! There's a boy here who's going to teach us to fly!
Can you really fly?
Mm-hmm. I'll teach you.
How lovely to fly!
I'll teach you how to jump on the wind's back, and then away we'll go!
Ooh.
Wendy, when you're sleeping in your silly bed, you might be flying about with me, saying funny things to the stars.
How do you do it?
Just think lovely, wonderful thoughts. And
I'm flying.
Look at me way
Ladies and gentlemen, Larry Hagman.
Goodness. I taught her everything she knows. As she is the first one to admit. But she's very philosophical about this. At the height of my career, when JR got shot and he got recovered and everybody found out who did it, I asked Mother if she'd like to go to Las Vegas and see a friend of mine, Joel Gray. And so she said, okie dokie. So we went down there and we were staying in another hotel, and we got out of the hotel, we're going to go over to see his show. And there was only one taxi waiting out in front. And the taxi cab driver saw me and he jumped out and he says, JR, get in the car. My wife will never forgive me if you don't drive in my car. And I said, no, well, my mother's right here and we have a big party. And so she said, no, darling, it's all right, you go ahead. You get in that one. And so he said, yeah, I don't want her, I want you. So as we pulled away, I leaned out the window and I said, that's show business, mama. So we got into the theater and we were halfway through Joel's show, and he stopped and he said, I'd like to introduce a couple of my friends in the audience. And the spotlight came around and he says, this is Larry Hagman of Dallas. And everybody just gave me a very nice applause, and it was super. And then he said, and now I'd like to introduce his mother, Mary Mar. And he just got that out, and they all stood up and applauded, and it went on for about 5 minutes. And she sat down and she says, and that's show business too, honey. Oh, my goodness. Well, I tell you, I'm really grateful for you, Mother, to have me, because otherwise, what the hell, I wouldn't be here, you know. And she's very proud to have JR for a son, and I'm very proud to have Peter Pan for a mother. Figure that one out. And we've only worked together once before in South Pacific. I was in the chorus of South Pacific, a little nepotism, but it's got me a long way. And she treated me exactly the way she treated everybody else, with love and concern and respect. And it made me understand why everybody who ever worked with her feels the same way I do. I'm so proud of you, Mother. Well, on that note, I want to introduce you to 90 men from the Navy who are going to go out here and sing.
The United States Naval Academy Glee Club.
Nothing to put on a clean white suit for.
We got nothing to look masculine and cute for.
There is nothing like a day.
Lots of things in life are beautiful, but brother, There is one particular thing. There's nothing whatsoever in any way, shape, or form like any other.